Hey everybody, I'm Holly Love.
I'm Rich Bonaducci.
And today on the show we got Mr. Kent Dunn and Rich reviewing movies.
That's right, we're talking two or three different films, so stick around.
And we're talking spray tans, because I got one.
You did?
Check me, looking tan.
Did you?
Tanalicious.
I can't tell. And welcome to the show. As promised, Kent Dunn is coming up later on, and we're going to chat all kinds of movies. We've seen two.
Yes.
Both of us have seen two, but I've seen one that he hasn't seen, so I'll get to tell him about The Light Between Oceans.
I want to thank you and Mr. Kent Dunn, may I, by the way?
Sure.
Because I have been traveling
we
for the first
cash.
Time. I don't have any. I've been traveling, so you have to take the thank you. For the first time in, like, I want to say 10 years, I actually sort of... I went and it was going to be a work vacation, and I literally couldn't work because in Florida, it's like the time difference was so hard because it's like 4 a.m. No one wanted to talk to me when I was waking up early in Florida.
Yeah, I don't buy it, but okay.
Anywho, but I really appreciate you guys filling in, and you did such a good job, except you did break my heart with a lot of movies, and maybe we can talk with him about that later.
But we have been getting better. Lately, the movies
have
been higher
quality.
The movies
have been getting better.
Yeah.
And you guys are a little happier,
yeah,
and it's
we're
a little less.
Happier these days.
But you guys are so cute. I love you guys on Fridays. You're my fave.
Well.
It's my Friday boys.
Okay.
Anywho, Rich Bonaducci, I got a spray tan.
You did?
I'm surprised you haven't, like, given me a hard time yet.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm looking pretty tanalicious right now because I haven't even showered yet. I'm at the phase where I probably shouldn't even be wearing this jacket because you're supposed to just let it, like, soak in.
I can tell you that I do disagree with your policies.
What policies?
But I would probably date Ivanka, too.
Are you saying that I'm a Trump? Right now.
No, I would never.
I haven't showered yet, so it's really, really strong. But it was so much fun. But I have. Have you ever spray tanned before?
Yeah.
Do you know that you get down to your birthday suit?
Yeah. That's one of the reasons why I do it.
So the thought occurred to me, but I knew you have like the little paper underwear option.
You know what? I did not use that the last time I did it.
So I went in. I was like, of course I'm gonna paper underwear because I don't want to, you know, just have to. But the good folks at Aesthetics Plus are so professional, first of all, and they do such a great job. I mean, they do, like, the real airbrushing. They were trying to give me a six-pack, but, you know, it's you have to actually...
Instead, they gave it to George Hamilton.
You wanted to do that so bad. You've been thinking about that since I got here.
I've got a few left.
Okay, good. I'll just keep rambling on.
Like, for instance, are you going to cry? You're going to cry, John Boehner? You're going to cry?
I don't know who that is except for someone in politics. John Boehner, which one's he?
He was the Speaker of the House.
Oh, yeah.
Before Paul Ryan. And he was
orange. Oh, he was always orange.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And he cried a lot.
I'm not going to cry. Anywho. Okay,
I'm glad.
Where was I at? I was at Aesthetics Plus.
I've got a million of them, frankly.
Getting down to your skivvies. Okay, so I put the little paper thing on, right? And I was like, okay, I'm good with this, not to mention everything else was... And I felt comfortable. But then I, like, saw the line... And I realized how, I mean,
just how
I am
pasty white you were.
Extremely pasty,
yeah.
People.
Yeah.
So this line, and so like about halfway through, I looked at Judy, who was the one doing the application of the spray tanner. I was like, we got to lose these. And she's like, yeah, we do. So we lost.
I can't tell, but you might actually be my color by now.
Actually be a color of a person?
I'm trying to say, you might be.
Yeah. Are you going to go do it?
Of course I'm going to do it.
Claudia, I was on the phone with her on the way here because, by the way... Because I just got one, and I talked to her on the phone on the way here, Claudia at Aesthetics Plus said...
You get a break.
$20 for a spray tan. Go in and say, Holly sent you, Talk 365 sent you, $20 for a spray tan. Of course, never any real contracts or commitments. They're always there, you know.
Exactly.
One at a time, but super professional. It smells really yummy. I don't have that weird spray tanny smell.
A lot of times to get that price, you do have to sign a contract that you'll do so many in 6 months or whatever. But
nope.
This is just, you want one, you want 10, whatever, 20
go
bucks.
Go on in and say Holly sent you.
There
and
you
then
go.
You have to go in. Are you gonna
what
get down?
What is this have to stuff? You had me at naked. I'm going.
Really?
Yeah.
Were you naked the last time? when you got a spray tan? You had to wear the little underwear?
No, I just hiked. I just cinched them.
Your own underwear?
And they got sprayed. But they came out. I didn't care. It's just underwear. It's not a dress shirt.
I've never had my face done before.
I had my top of my head done.
It's really cool because I think I look like I might have some ethnicity in me, and that's exciting because I don't have any melanin in my skin at all. Anyway, what have you been up to? What's been going on? I know we got to go soon. Kent is arriving.
I will say this. I am very sad today. You will know the day that we tape this because Oompa Loompa kind of hurts a little bit because Willy Wonka died today. Gene Wilder died.
Are you serious?
You didn't know?
No, I've been sort of busy. Wow.
Yep. I'm so bummed out. After this, I think I'm going to go home and watch Stir Crazy. I haven't seen it in a long time.
I love Gene Wilder.
Everybody loves Gene Wilder.
I love all the memes with just his face because it's so expressive.
Like, so, you're going to vote for Trump, huh?
Yeah. Or anything that is just like sarcastic. It's like, that's the face you pull because he's that good.
It's the most awesome face ever.
Oh, it's so good. We need to show 10 of them and I'll send you some of my favorite are my favorite.
Can you name your top three Gene Wilder movies?
So I've never seen one that I know I want to see.
What?
The Frankenstein one.
Oh, my Lord.
I know.
You have never seen Young Frankenstein?
No.
I will give it to you. I've got it. I will loan it to you.
Okay. So I haven't seen that, and I know I need to.
Yes, you most certainly do.
Of course, I love Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. That's like my childhood.
Except that's Johnny Depp, but go ahead.
No.
Yes, Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory.
Okay, I'm sorry, Willy Wonka. Of course, the original.
Hey, you said Charlie.
And then I can't think of another one. You tell me yours. Film guy?
I would say those two. I really enjoy those two and Blazing Saddles. You haven't seen Blazing Saddles? I will give that to you as well.
Okay.
It kind of peters out near the end, but it's really good up
That's
front.
And Mel Brooks,
and it could,
too?
Yes, and it could not be made today. Oh, my God.
Oh, I know. I've
there
heard.
Are so many other films by Gene Wilder, and Stir Crazy is one of them. He made four of them with Richard Pryor. They were like they were a team at the time. But anyway, go check it out. Just go online and get some Gene Wilder movies and have a drink and
enjoy
and toast to Gene.
Yoo-hoo.
Yeah.
Yoo-hoo for you.
Yoo-hoo was fine.
Yeah.
Sure, that'll
course.
Do.
Definitely. But okay, so that's a bummer. We're going to be talking more films with Kent coming up.
Yep.
These guys might be happy, and then I'm going to go because I kind of smell like spray tanner, and you guys are going to take over from here?
Yes, we are.
Are you going to miss me?
Absolutely.
Can I have one conversation with the two of you? Can I talk to Kent even at all? Because I feel like you monopolize Kent and you don't let me be on the air with the two of you at the same time. Like, I'm not cool enough.
Have you seen The Light Between Oceans?
No.
Have you seen...
See what he does? I'm, like, not cool enough.
No. It isn't a matter. It's cool. What are you going
to
say? You haven't seen anything. You haven't seen Young Frankenstein. You haven't seen Blazing Saddles.
Well, I didn't know where
And you said
about
it was Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
Fine. Can I at least, like,
Case
just
closed.
Introduce him and stand here and then leave?
Yes, you stand right here and say your thing, and you guys can chat for a minute.
And then I'll get out of your way and
Not
let
necessarily.
The professionals take over.
Not necessarily. If you have something to add to the movies, we would be very curious to know what that is, considering you haven't seen them. But, sure.
All right, don't go anywhere. I may be back. We'll see what really happens. It'll be a surprise. We'll see. Kent? What do you say? Do you like that guy up there?
He says nothing. Very diplomatic. Very diplomatic.
He's feeling nice.
Hold your breath. Make a wish. Count to three.
Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look, and you'll see into your imagination.
You trusted them to keep your loved ones safe. But each year, thousands of older Americans will fall victim to abuse under the watch of a nursing home or other care facility. If you or a loved one has been treated for an injury while residing at a care facility, call us now to connect with an attorney for the justice you deserve. Call the Rely On Group at 800-714-9662. That's 800-714-9662.
Talk 365 set design provided by Consign and Design.
Hey guys, welcome back. I actually got to stay. I have a time limit, and I am, yes, it will actually start beeping when it's time for me to go. But boys, I just want to say thank you, Kent, officially.
Oh, of course.
For hosting while I was away and busy and kind of trying to catch up from being away.
I'm no replacement at all, but I'm
you
happy
are.
To be
You're
here.
You're adorable, and everyone loves you. They love you too, Rich. Don't worry.
I'm just kidding you.
Oh, okay, thanks. And but I got to talk a little bit of, I got some problems.
On this show you want to talk about or after the show?
No, I want to talk right now because, quite honestly, you guys broke my heart a lot. Like, I would watch Fun Friday, and it wasn't that fun because I wanted to see Ghostbusters.
Yeah, we didn't stop you.
And you guys were just, like, racist, sexist boys. I loved how much crap you guys got for that. Can I say that word?
Yeah, you
boys?
Can.
Because
it was, we were boys.
Yeah, you got in some big trouble for that one.
A little bit.
That was kind of funny, actually.
Yeah, you know.
Because it was so obvious that that needed to be, like, basically not a, like, redo, but just a takeoff. Why didn't they do that? It was so simple.
It would have been so easy. Right?
I didn't even see it, and I know it.
Okay.
Right?
Well, maybe it's time for you to go see it, so you can prove us wrong.
I will before the panel.
Yes. Comic-Con, we got a panel coming up. Ghostbusters, where do we go from here kind of thing. So we'll do a little report on that. Basically,
I'll come.
It's back to the drawing board. Sorry.
You're a little too happy about that.
I know. I was really. I don't.
Yeah.
I don't get it.
So, did we break your heart for anything else?
Jason Bourne, by the way. I'm so excited to see that, and you're killing me, Smalls. Why?
I think we gave it like a B plus or a B minus. Sorry,
like
B minus.
Yeah, we're in a B range.
Nearly average.
Still, it's like Matt.
It's Matt Damon.
Matt Damon.
Killing it.
Doing Matt Damon.
Yeah.
As Jason Bourne.
I love him as
look,
those things.
If you like Bourne, you're gonna like the movie. That's what we said.
Okay, fine, I did.
Kay.
There was another one. What was the other one? I forgot.
Actually, watch art stuff.
I watch all of your stuff. I have you recorded. I take pictures.
She
I post you on Facebook.
To the end, and we're like C minus.
I'm like, dang it.
Again.
They're disappointing people.
It was a bad summer. It was just
I know
a bad
it was
summer.
A bad summer.
Just really average.
But it's getting better.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Cool.
And we're about to embark on a little thing where you two have a disagreement because I do watch your stuff. I'm like your biggest fans, number one. I watch you on Fox and I take pictures of you and I like post it on the
That's
air and your mama gets all happy.
That's true.
Hi, Mama Bonaducci. It's your favorite girl who takes pictures of your boy. Anywho, and I know that this like hold your breath thing, you hate it and you
like it.
Like it.
I don't know what you're talking about, to be honest with you. Hold your breath.
Blink. Don't blink.
Don't breathe. It's don't breathe.
You were holding your breath.
It's not don't breathe.
On the Fox thing. Show the picture of me taking you. You'll see. That's why I like did association.
I was just Doctor Whoing for a minute there. It's not don't blink.
Yeah.
It's don't breathe.
Don't breathe is
Good
the
luck.
Movie. Okay, so this is like a scary movie in the middle of like fall, August, why?
Yeah.
Getting us ready for October. It's too soon. I'm not ready. That's why I spray tanned. It needs to be summer just a little longer. Give me some action, fun, funny. Here you go. I'll leave now. I know. Thanks.
You know, you're even, the timer's not even up. You could stay, but.
I feel I should. Oh, beep, beep. You might hurt me.
It's going up.
Thank you.
Okay, of course I'll.
Have fun, boys. I'll try not to take out the set.
All right, that was Holly Love, everyone.
All right, well.
Huh.
Well, but basically the story is that Fassbender and Vikander are married, and they live on this island where it's a lighthouse, so they're isolated, and that's okay with them because he's a very private guy, and she just wants to be with him, so she brings him out of his shell, and they try to have a child, and they can't.
Okay.
She keeps miscarrying.
Hmm.
And one day, a boat washes up on shore with a dead guy in it and a live baby.
Okay.
Apparently, there was a shipwreck. This is on the trailer. I'm not ruining anything.
Hmm.
And so she's like, this is from God, you know, they gave us a baby.
No.
Let's just bury the guy and raise the baby.
Yeah.
And Michael Fassbender just wants to do anything for he adores her, and she might be postpartum, she might be ill, a lot of things, and he's just like, all right. He's not happy about it, but he does it. And for about 4 or 5 years, they just raise this child as their own because she was pregnant anyway, no one's the wiser.
Seems like a happy movie so far.
And he has this wonderful life he never thought he could have. This is after World War II, and he was a soldier, and he thought he was going to die in the war.
Hmm.
He's done some awful stuff in the war. He wanted the lighthouse job to live away from people and be isolated.
Hmm.
And he didn't think he would have a life like this. And he does. He has his family and this adoring wife. And then they go to town and find out that a woman lost her husband and child at sea.
Okay.
And he's certain it's this kid. And it is.
Could I ask you something, Mr. Sherborne?
Yes.
ships ever rescue people far out at sea? Or have you ever heard of little boats being picked up and survivors taken to the other side of the world, perhaps?
When it comes to the ocean, anything's possible.
I see.
Is that the entire movie? Did you just describe the movie?
No.
Or is there more?
Now there's what happens.
Okay.
You know?
Okay.
And it is very sad, but that part of the movie where they're doing their life together and everything, it's really great. It's a wonderful buildup. And Michael Fassbender is so good.
Oh, he's so good.
Oh my gosh, he's so good as this stoic, closed-off guy who has a glimmer in him that she sees. And she just brings him out, and how he slowly sort of blooms until he realizes, this, I can't have this life. This isn't my life. This is Rachel Weisz's life. And it's so sad. But the movie does add a sort of a Hollywood happy ending. If you've read the book, the ending is different.
Yeah.
And frankly, I really liked it. I mean, it's very sad, but it's good.
I'm trying to think of a good time I would actually want to go see a movie like this. I mean, I love seeing great film, but it's not like a Friday night, let's go to the movies.
No, it isn't.
See this,
it's not
movie.
Like, I can't wait to see Schindler's List. It's not one of these.
It's a quotable quote right there.
It's not one of these movies where you're like, yay!
Okay.
But for people that enjoy a really good drama, a bit of a tearjerker, although I was moved, but I wasn't moved to tears. It isn't that kind of thing. It isn't the one that's really tugging on
it's
you.
It's not quite a Nicholas Sparks formula, is it?
No.
Where it's, someone is going to die in the movie. There's this sweeping relationship and...
In the rain, under weeping willows
correct,
in Georgia.
Yeah.
No.
It's not that.
No, it's
has
not.
Has nothing to do with Nicholas Sparks.
No, it's not.
Fantastic.
And it's incredibly well acted.
Okay.
I would go see it just to see those guys again. But it is a tough movie. It's not a happy film for most of it, but I think it's a very well done, solid film, solid drama. I give it a B.
Okay.
And I would be very interested to see what you have to say.
I'll be seeing it in a few days, so I'm pretty excited.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good deal.
Yeah, even though I'm going to cry.
Maybe.
I don't have a heart. It's maybe. Okay. Yeah.
But we're going to come back and talk about movies that we both have seen. One of them, Morgan, or Alicia Vikander 2.
Basically. Yeah.
And of course, I'm sorry.
Don't even try to breathe.
What is it?
Don't breathe.
Don't blink.
Close your eyes.
Okay, yeah, don't breathe.
Critical Mass Moment is brought to you by The Movie Show, Sunday nights at 10 p.m. on KJAZZ TV.
Non-attorney spokesperson, attention women with ovarian cancer. If you or a loved one use baby powder before your diagnosis,
call 800-226-2156 now.
You may be entitled to compensation. For decades, medical studies have linked long-term use of baby powder with ovarian cancer. If you or someone you love was diagnosed with ovarian cancer after using baby powder,
call 800-226-2156 now.
Critical Mass Moment is brought to you by The Movie Show, Sunday nights at 10 p.m. on KJAZZ TV.
Welcome back to Talk 365. Kent Dunn is still here, and we are talking movies, two of them that we have seen now.
Yes.
We'll get to Don't Blink in a minute. First, we'll start with Morgan.
All right, so Morgan, strange sci-fi indie thriller is the only way to describe this movie. If you've seen Ex Machina from last year, it's similar to that, Twilight Zone-esque.
Yeah.
Essentially, Kate Mara, she plays this government/corporate operative going to check out some sort of cloning procedure that was done, really strange experiment, and she's there to shut it down if necessary.
Hello, Morgan. You know who I am?
Yes, of course. You're Lee Weathers, risk management consultant at SynSec.
And why am I here?
To assess my viability as a potential product stream in light of recent events.
How are you feeling, Morgan?
Not quite myself.
Morgan's been quite upset.
I didn't mean to hurt her. It was an error of judgment. I made a mistake.
It's okay now, Morgan. It's all right.
We'll talk about it tomorrow.
Yes, tomorrow.
Nice to meet you, Morgan.
So So basically, I was hoping for more than this movie gave me.
Okay.
I thought it was a cool thriller. It was actually pretty taut in some places, mm-hmm. although I think my heading, what I was writing was taut, tense, and telegraphs. Because, like, everything that came, I knew.
Well, it almost throws it out there. And it's like, we don't want there to be a twist here in the opening minutes.
We're going to tell you what's coming. Yeah.
In fact, I actually disagree with the tautness, because in the first 20, 30 minutes, yeah, there were some great characters, but it was a little boring. Hmm. I don't know if it was just my mood or what, but I was like, I know this is leading up to something good. Can we please get there? And then when it gets there, I'm like, oh, man, that was pretty bloody.
Yeah, yeah. And that's what I mean. When it starts to get to it, I'm like, whoa! But yeah. I was a little bummed that this movie that could have been some kind of discussion about what life is really all about, or the philosophy of this and that, turned out to, we made a monster and it's going to kill us.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, that's what this is.
Yes.
Yeah. It really wasn't
what I was expecting, though, because I thought it was going to be a straight horror film, where this is more a thriller. I'm not going to say psychological, but just a tiny sci-fi thriller.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, very strange. The cast is actually huge for a movie like this. And in fact, that's what totally drew me away from the movie. And there are great people on the cast, like Michelle Yeoh. We have Toby Jones, Kate Mara, like I said.
Paul Giamatti.
Paul Giamatti shows up in actually an unforgettable role.
As the worst psychoanalyst ever.
He was probably the best part for me. And it was a smaller part. But yeah, you're going to know exactly what's going to happen from the very first second. Just know that it's an action movie, and you'll actually be able to have a little bit of fun, because
there is some decent action.
When it's violent, it's cool.
Yeah, it's pretty decent action. But that action also gives away the twist.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So there you go. I mean, it's one of those things that I feel like if you saw it, you'd probably walk out going, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I got some action in there. I got some chick fights.
And it's probably best on Redbox, I would say.
Yeah.
This is the kind of movie where you're like, I spent $1.50 on that. Not so bad.
I'm sitting there going, I didn't pay for this. All right.
it's a charmed life.
Exactly. Yeah. All right, so let's get to the other one.
Okay.
Don't Breathe.
Why would you look at me like that?
Because I know what you think.
You shouldn't read my reviews.
I do. Set them up.
Okay, so Don't Breathe.
I'll knock it down.
Don't Breathe is one of the most intense thrillers. I'm just kidding. I'll start out differently for your benefit. Don't Breathe is very, very simple. We have three teens who like to steal. They like to break into homes and steal whatever they can just to make a quick buck. And they are looking for that big score. And when they find it, it's not quite what they expected.
Yes.
Who's there?
Okay, man, just chill, all right? Look, I was wasted and I wandered in, so that was my bet, all right? So I'm just gonna leave, okay? Stay right there.
Don't you move.
Yeah, that's right. I know what's in there, and I ain't leaving without it. You got me? Now you do as I say, all right? Do you hear me or what? I said stop. Don't you move. What are you gonna do now, huh? Huh? Stop! Stop!
How many of you are there?
So this movie, I didn't really expect much. I saw the trailer and I'm like, okay, that seems fine, home invasion thriller. And I could not even take myself out of the movie at all. I was sitting there gripping the sides of my chairs going, oh no, 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 please don't do that. Don't go into that room. Don't make that choice. And like almost yelling at the screen. And
oh,
just,
you were that guy in the movie?
I was that guy.
Man, shut up!
Yeah. Don't you go in there.
Shut up!
Don't you.
Try to watch a movie.
He's not dead.
Shut up!
So he's talking to me over there somewhere. But I walked out of this movie with a stress headache because I got so into the action that I was like, oh, man. And yes, a stress headache may not be what you want walking out of a movie.
You can get that in bad 3D.
But right? I was so involved in what was happening. I was like, hey, with all the flaws and everything, I had a blast.
Okay.
Yeah.
I will agree that it was tense.
Yes.
And I was kind of on board for a bit. I will say this, and maybe you'll agree, there really isn't anyone in the end. There isn't anyone to root for. They're all horrible people.
Yeah.
By the end of it, I'm almost to the point where I'm like, everyone in this movie deserves whatever they get. Except, what they get is so awful, I can't even say that. And Sam Raimi is a producer on this,
yeah.
And there's some Sam Raimi touches in there,
yeah.
But I didn't think they were played for laughs. I didn't think they were
tongue-in-cheek. No, there's no levity here.
Yeah, it's real serious, and there's some awful stuff that goes on. But not only that, I thought it went off the rails with what he can do in the house and the dog and through the vents and this and that and the windows. And eventually I went, now this is Home Alone with a Rottweiler.
Yeah, and that's, it kind of needed to be, because the house is a smaller house that they're in, and this is 90 minutes, and they have to somehow make this small house this carnival of terror. It's a maze, and it works. Like, for me, it was just, I felt claustrophobic with them even being in the house.
Yeah.
And so, yes, there is just, you know, they have to get out of incident after incident after incident, and you're like, oh, should I be tired of this? I never did get tired of
it. And for me, I felt like the incidents were getting more and more
ludicrous, in a way.
Yeah, ridiculous. And then the Cujo thing came and all that, and I'm like...
Yeah, but the Cujo thing, I mean, it's terrible.
So for me, it undermined everything it started with by getting too crazy in the end with all the elaborate stuff.
See,
but for you were along for the ride.
I was along for the ride. Yes, I didn't care about the characters all that much, except for maybe one of them. So, but I give this movie, I'm giving it an A-.
I know, I saw that.
Yeah, I'm sorry. It's just, I had so much fun with this. I will watch this at least a few more times.
For me, I gave it a C, which is average.
Yeah.
And I did that because I, like you, thought the setup and the device and all that was really cool.
Yeah.
But again, that latter half and near the end, I just went, oh, come on. And that, to me, undermined a lot of what it said.
Okay, understandable.
Well, tell you what, we'll just wrap the show up with you telling them how they can find your stuff.
Okay, you can find my stuff. If you want to find the written reviews, go to ShowtimeShowdown.com. Also, I have two podcasts. The first one is Bacon Cell. Second one is Podbash. You can go to iTunes, subscribe to that, however you like. It's pretty good stuff, so go check me out there.
Someone is telling me something about mention her shoulders. Oh, spray tans. Yes, Aesthetics Plus. If you want a spray tan,
I think we need
in the buff. See where I sat you? I sat you with the yellow one.
Oh, okay. thank you.
You can go to Aesthetics Plus and get it for $20. $20 for a full body spray tan. That's a really good price, actually. No contracts required. Just check them out. Aesthetics Plus, $20 spray tan. There you go.
Nice.
All right. Thanks for watching the show. And Holly will be back maybe Monday.
Thanks, boys.